All right, here we go. Jason DeBeas. I'm in the Motherlode. I'm in Aspen, Colorado. This is court two, next to center court. That guy hitting the ball just off the top of the tape and just out is Mark Burik. His partner is Jeffrey Samuels. I kept calling him Kennedy Samuels. It's actually B. Samuels. The opposition, Jesus Lopez. Serving is Mr. Sherman. They're both out of Arizona. They're leading 1-0 in the match, but leading 1-0 in the set, but trailing 1-0 in the match. Line over, got it. One apiece. Mark Burik, originally from Queens, New York. One of the bigger stands at George Mason University. Has played with a slew of partners and against basically everyone you can come up with, old names to new. Got a little serve out of position four, outside set, and shaves the pits. Jeff brings it back, looking for two. Burik! This Let's Go Tape monster is getting a lot of touches today. Once again, Aspen, Colorado, this is the Motherlode. Along with all of these cool people next to me, I'm Jason DeBeas. Lopez to serve. Lopez serve out of the middle. A little bit of a J-hook pass. And Mark, nice set. Wasn't sure if he's completely square, but there's your line over. And now, leading 3-1 is Team Sherman and Lopez. I'm absolutely stoked and excited to be here. My first time in Aspen, Colorado. For sure my first time for Motherlode. Jeff Samuels, of course, no stranger to being here. I think he's last year's champion, and wow, nice read on that. And Sherman, wrist away, Doug, and wow, I don't know what hit the floor first. And Jeff restores order. Nice timing on the jump and block by Jeff Samuels.
Jason, how you doing?
What's up, baby? Looking good.
Thanks, brother.
Jealous of your shades.
$20 on Amazon, bro.
Yeah. And see what I waste my money on?
You look slick.
Jeff Samuels, like I said, no stranger to Motherlode. Won last year. Won 3 years prior, 4 years prior with Casey Jennings. Casey Jennings is a net violation and... We're at 4-2 and we're one away from the switch. Once again, for those of you that just joined me, thank you for having me in your living room. Thank you for having me in your life. This is the second set. They lead by two, but they trail 0-1 in the match. Looking to bring it to a decisive third set. And I got a feeling. I think tonight's going to be a good night. But I think right now is where it's at. Excellent pass. Nice hold on his platform. Burik, line over. Got it for the switch. Something I thought Mark has shown significant improvement in was cruise control. He was one of those guys that used to go 100% every play from beginning to end in a match, and now he's found a way to operate at 90%, and beach volleyball, energy efficiency is the key. And when you play in that deep sand in Manhattan Beach and Hermosa Beach, you got to be efficient with your energy. Set to the outside, drifter. Nice patience on a two-block switch by Mark. Mark sneaks it in. Shaving the armpits of Lopez is Mark Burik. Mark Burik, a.k.a. the hardest working man, a.k.a. the James Brown of volleyball, will serve 4-4. Fixing that score for you guys. Jeff with the dig. Looking for transition, Jeff. Jumbo shrimp, Doug. Who's going to get to five first? Is it going to be Lopez? Whoa, there's a block. Nice patience. Nice timing by Jeff Samuels. Would love to see Sherman get over there and cover. I know his partner should be grateful for turning a lemon into lemonade, but the score has no feelings. I just called him Samuel Less. I gotta change that. Samuels and Burik. How's that? We're at 5-5. Jeff Samuels out of Flint, Michigan. Spent a little bit of time, a couple of years in Hermosa Beach. Did a little club coaching on the side for a group called Endless Summer. Good group of coaches that had Andrew Dentler. Miles Evans was there for like a cup of coffee. Pompilio, Arturo. It's a nice serve, but an even better pass by Mark. Once again, nice balance and still trying to find a way to hold his platform. The end is Mark Burik. So besides Mark's significant improvement on his energy efficiency, operates on at something I like to call a competitive cruise control. That's an oxymoron if I ever heard one, but he also used to be extremely hot-headed, and now, I guess, I don't know, I guess with age you kind of cool off. Lopez ties the score again, 6-6. Good things happen when you hit the crap out of it. And now we're at 6-6. Sherman with the serve. Ooh, hits the top of the tape, and this let's go net has gotten a lot of W's so far this set. Burik to serve. Burik's got a pretty good jump serve. He elects to go float on that one, and that one left balloons into the net. And there's your switch. So down 1-0, what does Sherman and Lopez have to do to come back and win this? I think as long as they serve Lopez, he has to continue to use power to set up his shot. Lopez on a couple of plays when he was shooting, his body language and his jump showed shot. And when it shows shot, it's very, very easy for Mark Burik to read. So continue to jump for power and use that to set up shot. Or just stay with power. Good things happen when you hit the crap out of it. The second thing they need to do is they have to serve a little bit tougher. It's been quite a little bit of a lollipop competition, and if you serve Burik lollipops, you get licked. Little in and out on that one, and splits the uprights, but I think it hit one of the pins, hit one of the bars for the extra point, and the score is now 8-8. Expect Lopez to get the rest of the serves. By that rationale, what does Burik and Samuels have to do to win? I think the same thing applies. I think Mark Burik has a very terrific jump serve. And I think a lot of these spots that they're serving, short form, middle, that serve to space can be problematic for the underdogs. Jeff Samuels, wow, Talk about fluid hands. There's a guy that no one talks about enough as far as setting is concerned. 9-8. You think of good setters, you think of Skyla Del Sol. There's a Motherlode product if we ever heard one. I think of Rafa Rodriguez. I think of, on the women's side, Sarah Sponsel. Of course, Larissa from Brazil has been using hands when every other female competitor was using their forearms. And we got a sky ball coming. Marcus hit 100% of them at the qualifier in Manhattan Beach. Oh my goodness! A backdoor dig. And I'm very curious what the call is on this one. I gotta fix them. I'd love to know what the call was on that. Was there a net?
But I thought it touched him here.
Oh, okay, so yeah. So the basket catch coverage might have hit his shoulder on the way down. Mark Burik, and even when he misses, he can't miss. There's a backwards pass, and that's what they need to do, continue to set up with their serve. And Burik gets blocked by the let's go again. Once again, the let's go tape has been getting a lot of W's in this one set alone, never mind the match. Lopez to serve. 9-10. This is a nice set. That's a little tight for Jeff. Jeff Samuels has been a blocking machine. Spoke to him a couple of weeks ago and asked him how he feels like physically, and he says he feels great. 2019, 2020, he's had a lot of nagging, undisclosed injuries that kind of made him shut down half his season and then come back at volleyball from a different angle. But those are the things that Jeff does when he feels good physically. There's a lollipop serve. There's the up and down set, and nice move on the cut, but luff balloons out of bounds. And there's your technical timeout. Take a short little break, and I'll be back. One of my favorite volleyball songs. It's all about that bass. Right? Base defense, all about that base. Why hasn't anyone done a video of that? Like, all about that base? I love
that. Don't worry.
I will. Yes. She put this song on loop for like...
Oh no, that would make me insane.
I know. It's like, this is torture. It's not torture, it's therapy. Therapy. Yeah, Megan Trainor, that is cruel, unusual punishment. You're right. What's your name?
Christy.
Jason. Along with Christy, I'm Jason DeBeas. We are back. Her last name is none of your business. And the heavy favorites lead by 3 and also lead 1-0. Samuels with the jump floater goes to soft 1. Wow. Once again, great elevation and good selection, but sails out of bounds and scoring first off the technical timeout is Team Burik and Samuels. I expect Jeff to go back to position 1. Yep, and again, this let's go tape is winning a lot of battles today. Dig pink, side out foundation. sand. Let's go. All sponsors of the Motherlode tournament here in Aspen, Colorado. A little low pass, shooty pass, and that's something Burik probably doesn't want to do as the tournament continues, but the net result is pretty good. And that's 14-10. Once again, Mark Burik, George Mason standout outside hitter. Multiple time Pottstown Rumble winner. And that might be his first miss in quite some time. Score is 11-14. What kind of player is Mark Burik? Mark Burik, a few years ago, missed the play-in at San Francisco AVP. But instead of crying and drinking his sorrows away, he gets on a plane, goes to the East, goes to the Pottstown Rumble, wins Hudson Bates. Mark Burik with the teardrop, Cuddy. All momentum right now to Samuels and Burik. Jeff Samuels. Whatever's in the drinking water where he's from that makes him jump so high. We should all get a glass. Actually, no, that's Flint, Michigan, so let's take that back. Left shoulder serve, and again, an ankle pass. I think something I'd like to see a little bit better from all four competitors. And the question is, trailing by three, who are they going to go to and how are they going to go to him? There's the up and down set. Mark Burik again, very similar to the first shot. Hard cross court, very rangy hitter on the right side. Hello, the guy checking the height of the net to see if it's high or low. I watched the Masters yesterday. That was a low net, guys. Actually, I take that back. The Masters tournament in general, just to rinse and repair, was one of the better spectacles I've seen in a long time. You got 37 and above, or 37 minimum, was just amazing competitors. And a lot of those guys are in the open, and there's another block, just been a blocking machine. Yeah, but I really loved watching the Masters yesterday. Dana Camacho. There's an old head, a name from the past and present, and that was playing in the tournament. Got a spin serve, and there's the up and down set again, and again, problematic for Jeff the Wall Samuels on this. Jeff was a blocking machine in the Manhattan Beach Open in the main draw. He had 13 blocks in one match in a contenders bracket match against Jimenez and Penberthy. Playing with a consistent partner at the time, Chris Vaughn. Samuels and Burik, a heavy favorite to win this. The very, very high volleyball IQ and mature partnership. A team that doesn't cut corners. They don't sacrifice technique for fancy points. Though Mark Burik, you might see hot dog it sometimes, and challenge shot by Sherman. There he stood in the doorways, Jeff Samuels, so far. 6 blocks. $13.19. There's the back set. Burik challenges. It's a great challenge shot by Mark, who saw the 4-block switch and could have easily cut, but I'm not mad at the challenge shot. I'm even less upset at the block. 14-19. They go to Burik and kind of steam shovels the pass, and once again, good things happen when you hit the crap out of it. Match point opportunity number one. We're going to see a switch, or we are going to see a match. Very, very happy to be here and see new faces, new competition. Or to them, old competition. And Jeff trying to field the punt on that one and muffs the punt and recovered by the other team. Most likely the last switch of the match. And this is the kind of rhythm Samuels and Burik want to have. They're just starting this tournament. I actually don't see either competitor sweating. Not an ounce of sweat on either one of those guys. Not in their body or their palms. Burik goes line. And sometimes you just got to hit. And no net on that one. That's 21. Oh, did he net? Oh, little Nemo? Okay, Spider-Man does whatever a spider can. Caught in the web is Mark Burik. $16.20. They're going back to Burik. Yes, they will. Position one, and little bit of a J-hook pass on Burik on that one, and now it's $17.20. Sometimes when you angle your platform and face forward, both forearms are facing up. And sometimes it can go to the target, but you gave the ball permission to do other things, and now it's $17.20. Jeff Samuels calls it a J-hook. Going back to Burik, I expect him to go right shoulder. No, left shoulder position one, why not? Jeff Samuels with the fluidity, and Burik. Always an advocate for the dramatic. Now makes it 18-20. I actually like the left shoulder serve, and I want to see if they do it again. Jeff Samuels feels like he's been standing still for a little bit, and now needs to see where the server's set up. There you go, and got your screen, and now there's a situation trailing by two. Wow, nice second move on the midline, and Burik finishes in classic fashion, cut over. Winners, 2-0. This last set, 21-18, is Burik and Samuels over Sherman and Jesus Lopez. We got more to come later, guys. But for now, I'm Jason DeBiz. Love you guys. Stay with me. I'm out.